On that very same morning, as he did every morning, the Buddha extended his divine eye to survey the entire world, looking for one who was ready and suitable to receive his divine help. The Buddha saw that on this day, Angulimala would encounter his mother. Until this moment, Angulimala had cultivated enough paramitas to be able to become enlightened in this life. However, if Angulimala were to kill his mother, he would have committed one of the 5 anantarika-kammas, heinous actions that block any chance of enlightenment in this life, and lead to an immediate rebirth in hell. The 5 anantarika-kammas include intentionally killing one's mother, intentionally killing one's father, killing an arahan, causing a schism within the sangha, the community of monks and nuns, shedding the blood of a Buddha. If Angulimala were to commit an anantarika-kamma, the magnitude of this kamma would prevent him from attaining any stage of enlightenment in that lifetime. After his death, he would be reborn in Avicii Niraya, the lowest level of hell. There, he would spend countless lifetimes enduring unspeakable torment and pain. Each time he died in hell, he would be reincarnated back in the same place and forced to go through the torment and suffering again. The Buddha, in his infinite compassion for the suffering of lost souls, walked to the location where Angulimala was about to meet his mother. Angulimala was perched in a tree in the forest. He was waiting for a hapless traveler to prey on. Angulimala had amassed 999 fingers. This would be the final finger needed to complete his quest. Angulimala could see a woman walking down the path towards him. Angulimala's mother, Mantani, shook with fear as she walked in the quiet forest. She was scared and wanted to go home, but her instincts as a mother moved her to keep proceeding in order to save her son. After not too long, with his good eyesight, Angulimala recognized that the scared woman was his mother. However, Angulimala just thought, "The sooner I get this done, the sooner I can begin helping people with the wisdom in the scroll. If my mother must supply the 1,000th finger, then so be it. I can just revive her after I complete the quest." However, Angulimala noticed another person on the path walking towards him. It was a monk. Given the choice between killing his mother or the monk, Angulimala easily chose the monk. Little did he know that the monk he chose as his target was not any regular monk, but the Lord Buddha himself. Angulimala leapt down from his hiding spot, expecting to cleave his target in one strike. However, something strange happened. No matter how fast Angulimala ran, or how hard he tried, he could not gain any ground or get closer to the Buddha. In fact, the faster he ran, the greater the distance seemed to grow between them. This greatly shook Angulimala. In the past, he was able to chase down even the fastest horses. How could a monk, who was merely walking, be beyond his grasp? Angulimala screamed out,
"Monk! Stop!"
The Buddha, without stopping, said, "Angulimala, I have stopped. It is you who has not stopped." Angulimala yelled out,
"Monk, it is wrong for you to lie so blatantly. Anyone can see that you are walking, and therefore have not stopped. I am standing here. Obviously, I have stopped. How could you lie so shamelessly? It is not befitting of a monk."
The Buddha then said, "Angulimala, I have stopped. I have stopped harming others. I have stopped all my desires. I have stopped all my attachments. Therefore, I have stopped creating karma. Therefore, I have stopped all future rebirths. You, however, have not stopped. You continue to kill and harm others, which will lead to undesirable karma and rebirths. You have guaranteed that you have suffering ahead of you. It is you who is not stopped." The depth of the Buddha's words pierced through any resistance Angulimala had. It felt as if the Buddha was speaking directly to his heart. Angulimala dropped to his knees, releasing any semblance of resistance. He knew then and there that the monk in front of him was not just any monk, but the Lord Buddha. Angulimala raised his hands in reverence. The Buddha, seeing that Angulimala was ready to receive his help, said, "Angulimala, all creatures in this world value their lives. They do not want to be hurt. They do not want to die. This is a universal truth. Killing and harming others creates undesirable karma. It creates a karmic contract for which you must be reborn in suffering states to fulfill."
"My lord, you are right. I was foolish to think that I could kill people in order to help them. My actions have only caused pain and suffering for others and for myself. I see the error of my ways. I repent, my lord. I repent. Please guide me. Please teach me. Please be my refuge out of the darkness."
Angulimala got up and disposed of all of his weapons and tools of murder. He returned and bowed at the Buddha's feet.
"Please, my lord, accept me as your humble disciple. Guide me towards the path that you have gracefully walked, so that I may follow in your footsteps. And so, Angulimala became a disciple of the Buddha.
What did you learn from this story? We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.